Creator, you just shot your epic masterpiece. You got in your DaVinci Resolve. You did your editing. You got your editing done. And now it's time to post that sucker to YouTube. What you don't want to do is make some crazy mistakes and upload a video that you rendered improperly and don't allow your video to shine at its best potentials. I'm going to show you some DaVinci Resolve output settings that will help you go a long way. And I've done a lot of research on this. There's a bunch of varying opinions. And so I'm mixing it with what I know about the way Final Cut renders, because as Apple, and so of course it sort of renders one of the best because, well, they wrote the codec, never mind that's terminology, and then the things that are the best for the way YouTube wants it to be. By combining these two settings, we can get some really incredible output and your videos will look Oftentimes I get comments on my videos like, how does your video look so crisp? And it isn't just the way that you shoot the video. A lot of it has to do with the way you render. So does it help you to have a really nice setup and nice video quality? And then when you render it, it comes out looking weird, okay? And just imagine a really beautiful outfit that was folded improperly and it came out with a bunch of creases and wrinkles and it no longer looked good. It's like that. Let's pop into DaVinci Resolve real quick. So we're gonna come over here and here's just a timeline of some clips that I put together kind of mucking around. And if you're on the edit page here, you're going to go all the way down to the bottom where you see the little rocket ship and go here. You're going to see this little rocket ship. That's how you get to the delivery page. And when you come to the delivery page, there are going to be some output settings here at the top. So as you slide across here, there's custom export, H.264, 265, you know, things that you're all used to seeing. And there is a custom YouTube export here. And if we press this, this is kind of okay. You can just go here and you'll be sort of fine, but I think there's some things that you can do to give it a little bit of extra pop and circumstance. So I won't necessarily use that. Today, we're gonna go ahead and create a custom export, okay? So you're gonna name the file name, whatever you wanna do. YouTube export test. Okay, we'll just call it that. And then we're gonna come down here. We want it on single clip and we wanna have it on video. Now for the format, you got two choices. You can either press MP4 or you can press QuickTime. Both of them are the same reality. There's a lot of conversation between whether MP4 is better than MOV and it's a useless argument. It's an envelope. Pick whichever one makes you happy. I'll leave it on MP4 because that's just what I've done for the longest time. Now, if you have a modern Mac, you should be able to check this hardware acceleration. If you have a PC, your graphics card will show up in here. It will say NVIDIA or whatever type of graphics card you had. So you want to check that box. This bottom one doesn't really matter. For your resolution, this is very important. I'm going to select the 3840 by 2160 Ultra HD. Now, I know some of you are thinking to yourself, well, I shot this 1080 video. Why am I going to send it out at 4K? You always want to send it out at 4K. And the cool thing about it is DaVinci is smart enough to scale the video up. So even if you shot it at 1080 and you edited at 1080, you can export it at 4K. A lot of times what I do is I shoot it at 4K, but I edit at 1080. And then when I tell it to export at 4K, it will go get the original files and with the edits that we've made and output a quality video. But YouTube knows what to do and DaVinci knows what to do. So go ahead and scale that sucker up. I even do this in Final Cut. If you're a Final Cut user just bored watching this video, I still always change the timeline to 4K at the end and let that sucker out. Anyway, back in here. So we're going to embiggen this again. Let's come here. So you want to set that. And then for your frame rate, this I have it set for 30 because that's what I did this particular timeline on. But if you're at 24, you can do that. If you're at 25, you can do that. You can just kind of pick or you can just choose the timeline frame rate. Now, this is where you're going to see this initially set up on yours, it's going to probably say automatic. I'm going to change this to here. And in here, you're going to manually type in 100,000. 80,000 also works. I would kind of leave it up that high. And I know this sounds absolutely insane because it's going to make a massive file on your computer and YouTube is going to eventually smash it down to about 48 to 50. But if you start with it high, your output will be better. You don't really have to touch much else here, like the encoding profile. High is fine. Auto also works. I just like if you leave it on high because it makes the best. Now, here's one way you can also ensure you get really good looking video is to press multipass encode. It is going to take longer for your video to calculate, but it will ensure you the absolute best. You kind of need to figure out what you made in your video. So what makes you decide whether to press this or not? In my opinion, what it would be is if you're doing a bunch of effects that has a lot of dissolves, things where you're going to be using a lot of fades or a lot of gradients, or your room even has a bunch of weird gradients. So for instance, if I turn on my back lights back there and they start moving around and I don't want them to get all muddy in the export, I would probably put on the multi-pass filter. In here, for this particular test, I'm going to leave multi-pass off. And then in the advanced settings, the only thing you're going to want to mess with here is color space. And this is crazy complicated, but the only thing you really need to know about is if you can find, stop moving so fast. You want Rec 709. That's the answer. And then same with the project, you're going to pick Rec 709. That is the most common, the most normal. 709A is the best. I didn't see that in here, but yes. So you're going to select Rec 709. I use same as project because I already set my DaVinci up to output as Rec 709. So let me show you where I did that, so that way you would understand. If I were to go into my timeline settings here by pressing a little cog in the bottom corner or shift 9, and you go into master settings, come down to where it says color management, my color science, I leave it at DaVinci RGB, YRGB. But in my timeline color space, I selected Rec 709 Alpha. And then in my output color space, I selected Rec 709 Alpha. So that's why I leave mine the same as timeline. I think they're super important to have those set up when you set up your project. And if you do make this change, you don't want to have to think about that again because it's, you know, it's a lot. If you click on the three dots up here at the top and you come down to say set as default preset, then it's always going to be like that. And you don't have to worry about it. It'll make your job heck of a lot easier. Okay, so let's go back over here to the edit page, to the output page, I mean. So we're going to leave that same, and then you can go ahead and close that because that's going to be there. And then we don't really need to worry about the subtitle settings. So once you're done with that, again, DaVinci loves these little three dot areas. Click on the three dots and then say create an additional video. I'm sorry, save as a new preset. And then let's move this to where we can see, and we're going to call this BESTESTYOUTUBE settings. All right. And then you'll be good to go. That will be all you need to do in order to get like a real swanky output. Now, one of the things that comes up a lot, you'll see there is the H.264 output and the H.265 output here at the top. And the reality is, on the Mac, H.265 will render a heck of a lot better. It's faster the whole nine yards. But H.264 is still the most compatible. And considering we don't know what people are going to play on, I'm going to actually take a step back and do it in H.264 from now. When I was doing all my outputs in Final Cut, I always use H.265. But statistics state more and more people are watching from TVs. And I think it's just better to use the most compatibility, because although I have Sony TVs, if someone has like an Insignia or some other weird thing, you want to make sure your colors render the best possible. Or they got Apple TV or Fire Stick or Roku or this other new thing that cable box companies are handing out, which I forget the name of. It's a weird name. You don't know what kind of player people are using. So I feel that H.264 has the most compatibility with pretty much anything that's on the market. You know what we say around here? I don't know who needed to see this, but if it was you, let me know in the comment section below. And if you use these settings, they will give you the best output when you hit to YouTube. YouTube will do the rest. It's going to do some compressing, and yes, you're going to make a massive file. Now, if you live somewhere with really, really slow upload speed, you might back that 80,000 down to like 60,000. Just to give yourself a little smaller file. but I have, you know, gig fiber, so I'm going to push 100,000 every time, because you know what they say, garbage in, garbage out, right? Even if you needed to make a 1 foot by 1 foot by 1 foot box, if you start with 5 board feet of wood, you got a better chance of making a better box, because if you make a mistake or whatever, you got more to go on. So it's sort of like that, but not a renewable resource. If you like this video, press the like button, press the subscribe button, ring the notification bell. This is DaVinci Resolve over 40 in 30 day 24, and we only have a few more days left. So if you have anything that you want to see that we haven't covered so far, make sure you drop that down in the comment section below. And right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video of things you watch, and I agree with them.
I need to know everything, who in the what and the where, I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but I like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George, I hop in the Porsche, 5 and a horse, I'm ready for war, I'm coming for throws to turn to a ghost, I need to know everything. Now you be surprised at the info you get, is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them in talk.